We'll go over the following configuration tasks required to integrate Oracle ERP Cloud Budgetary Control with Oracle EPM Planning Financials Budget Revision. Enable financials with budget revisions. Complete configuration tasks for financials. Import metadata. Add entries to the control budget name smart list. And assign access permissions to rules applicable to budget revisions. Make sure to assign the required access permissions to EPM Planning Financials artifacts. For more information on access permissions, see the Setting Up Access Permissions section in the Administering Planning documentation. Related videos and tutorials are listed in the description. Before starting the setup process, make sure to review the configuration and integration considerations listed in the hands-on tutorial. The What Do You Need section also lists the minimum requirements for the setup. To ensure that the dimensions map between Oracle ERP Cloud and EPM Planning Financials, you can modify dimension names in EPM Planning Financials before enabling features. Alternatively, you can map dimensions in data integration. I'll rename Entity to Department. After making metadata changes, you must refresh the database to commit changes to the application. However, in this case, the database is refreshed when you enable features in financials. You must enable expense planning and use your own chart of accounts in EPM Planning Financials rather than using the provided chart of accounts. Learn more by stepping through the configuring financials to bring in your own chart of accounts in planning and leveraging best practice planning in financials using your own chart of accounts tutorials. Scroll down and select budget revisions and select the additional options you need. If you select only budget revisions, EPM Planning Financials provides metadata required to perform budget revisions. This option allows planners to create, populate, and share revisions. Selecting import balances from budgetary control enables integration of encumbrance accounting, allowing you to track encumbrance balances. This creates a scenario dimension member called OEP underscore consumed, as well as associated trends for revising budgets. You can use this option to import any encumbrance, obligation, or commitment balances from budgetary control into EPM Planning Financials. Selecting Update Budget Changes in Budgetary Control enables funds reserved to budgetary control to update budget balances and funds available in budgetary control from EPM Planning Financials. Selecting Review Budgetary Control, Impact Before Approving Budget Changes, enables funds checked to budgetary control within EPM Planning Financials before a budget is approved. Specify the number of active budget revisions you can have, up to 30 active revisions. You can change this number later. Specify a prefix to add to the system-generated revision numbers. This revision number is the unique identifier of the revision in budgetary control. Scroll down to map rename dimensions, enable custom dimensions associated with a feature, and set one of the dimensions as the primary dimension for display along with the entity dimension on the rows instead of on the page on forms. You can select other features you want to enable. Keep in mind that with budget revisions, you must use your own chart of accounts in EPM Planning Financials rather than using the provided chart of accounts. I'll initiate the enablement process. It takes a moment to complete. When finished, sign out and sign back into planning. Let's complete configuration tasks for financials. If you configured features other than those explicitly covered in the previous section, make sure to complete post-configuration tasks required for those features. For more information, see the Administering Planning Modules documentation. I'll set the time frame and granularity for my plans. On the left, select the current fiscal year, period, and plan start year. On the right, select the planning frequency for each scenario. You use the plan scenario to create your initial budget, forecast for your forecast, and adopted budget for budget revisions. Save your selections. Next, let's configure budget revisions descriptive information to create custom fields for budget revisions. This task is optional. The custom fields are added to the budget revisions forms so users can add more details for revisions. Adding metadata using this configuration task ensures that members are added in the correct location in the account dimension hierarchy. The dimension members must match between EPM Planning Financials and Oracle ERP Cloud Budgetary Control. I'll import metadata into Financials. For each dimension, select your metadata file. Make sure that your metadata files are valid prior to importing. Then, run the import process. When making metadata changes, you must refresh the database to commit changes to the application. When you enable budget revisions, a smart list control budget name is created. You add smart list entries to define each of the control budgets that you want to integrate. Entry labels must be an exact match with control budget names in budgetary control. This provides options in the user interface that allows users to create budget revisions for a specific control budget. Next, rules. EPM Planning Financials includes rules used to calculate and push data for budget revisions. You'll need to provision users or groups with permission to launch these rules. In the rules card, set access permissions to these rules as appropriate. Prepare for revisions, create and populate revision, and share revision. I'll quickly show you the steps. Apply the same steps to these rules. I'll head over to Rule Security and assign access permissions to these rules. Select the rule and click Assign Access. You can assign permissions to users or groups. I'll assign launch permission to a user. When completed, the users with assigned permission are listed in this dialog. Related videos and tutorials are listed in the description. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.